Okay, let's have a look at the first A part. So I'm going to break it down. Again, I'm only going to separate the notes that are the same by cut. So let's see if we can get the phrasing and the feel going. So it's nice and steady. One, two. If you noticed in the first time bar, I missed out the little F sharp pickup note. The reason I did that was because it's a good place just to grab a breath. So we can sacrifice that little pickup note to grab a breath. Okay, so the A part. Now what we're going to do is going to introduce some cuts. So I'm going to deal with each section separately. So we're going to add a few cuts now into the A part. So we're going to go. So I'm cutting the A, and then in the second measure, I've cut the G in that second group of three. So the next measure, same thing, I'm cutting the A. So on that last measure on the first line, I'm just going to let my breath carry that. I'm not going to add any cuts to that bit. So first measure on the second line, same thing. So, cutting the A. So second measure, second line. I've cut the G. And then the last two measures. So what I've done is separate those two A's in the first time bar with cuts. So let's put that together now. So I've added the cuts. I'm going to play it through just with the cuts. To the second time bar after the repeat. So again, separating those two A's. So I've separated those two A's with the cuts. Okay, so this is a great piece for adding some long rolls. And so if we remember the long roll, it's the note, the cut, the tap. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just play the long roll on the A, long roll on the A, and a long roll on the G, because I can do a nice little variation. So long roll on the A, note, cut, tap. So the first measure. Okay. And the same thing in the third measure. So what I like to do with this, it's just a little variation on the A part, is to put a long roll on the second group of three notes in the second measure. So. So I turn. So instead of playing G, F sharp, G, I play a long roll, G. So. And the same thing on the next line. So let's put that together, play it through twice. So nice and steady. One, two. Okay, so on to the B section. So we're starting with, again, I don't play the pickup D because it's a good place to grab a breath. So I'm just going to go and play it as written first and then show you with some cuts, and then I'm going to add some other ornamentation to the B part. So here we go. So breaking that down, just as written. So again, now I like to cut. So I'm cutting the F sharp, I'm cutting the G. So. And then, so that line, third line. So fourth line, again we've got, so I'm just going to play those straight for now, so because we're going to long roll those eventually. So it's going. I'm cutting the high A, so again. And then we get to the next bar. I'm going to cut the F sharp and the A and then the G. So those last two bars of the B section. Again. So cut the F sharp, cut the A, cut the G, and then just play the D. So putting that together now. Okay, so with those long notes, we can't really roll a C sharp and we can't roll a D, but what we can do is we can crown the D and we can do a long crown on the D. So the other way of doing it is just to do a little variation on what's written. So rather than playing the long C and the long D, so rather than playing, we can play those as three notes. So you can go, and then the D. So I like to play C sharp, B, C sharp, and then D, C sharp, D. So we can go. Just makes it sound a little bit fuller. The other thing you can do is to do a little crown on the D. So you can go. But I don't really want to get into crowns here because it's quite a specialist ornament which takes quite a lot of practice to get right. What I'm going to do is I'm going to do a separate tutorial on crowns at some point soon, but just to know that it's an option which you can use once you've got your head around crowning. So for now we'll just go. Okay, so again. So beginning the fourth line, so that's the second half of the B part, we've got long roll on F sharp, long roll on G. So we can go. And again. So I'm cutting that high A on the second measure of the fourth line. So long roll F sharp, long roll G. Cut the high A like this. And then we're just going to add the cuts there. So I'm going to play the whole of the B part now. And I'm going to add the long rolls, the cuts, and the variation on the two long notes at the beginning of the B, beginning of the third line. So it's going to go. Okay folks, we're on to the third and part, or the C part. So here we've got a lot of cuts going on here. So what I'll do is I'll play it slowly and I'll go through each bar. So the first bar, which is going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, beginning of the fifth line. So I'm going A, G, cut the G, cut the A, G, E. So second measure. So A, G, E, cut the E, D, cut the D. So again, those two measures. Oh, lots and lots of cuts in there. So again. You can substitute the cuts for some cuts for taps if you want. So you could go. But I prefer the cuts. They just give it a little bit more of an accented emphasis. So it's up to you. I mean, you can try taps if you like. So the next two measures on the fifth line. Now again, we can the last note, we can do a long roll on that G, so it'll go. Yeah, long roll, note, cut, tap. So I'm going to play the fifth line, the first part of the C section. And again, I'll do it slower. Okay, so pretty much the same with the last line, same cuts. So same thing again. So it's A, G, cut the G, A, cut the A, G, E. So A, G, cut the G, cut the A, G, E. Cut the A, G, E, cut the E, D, cut the D. So we've got a real cutting festival here. Now you might need to practice that slowly and carefully, because as I said, there's a lot of cuts which are happening fairly rapid succession. So again, and then the last two measures. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to play the C section with the cuts and the rolls. Okay, so that's A, B, and C. So I'm going to play all the way through now, nice and steady. So I'm going to do it with a click as well. So I'll probably set my click to a fairly steady kind of maybe 72 beats. So this is the whole tune with the click. Okay, I've set my click to 60. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do one at 60 and probably one a little bit quicker. So the first one at 60. So here's the click. Now with 6/8, it's compound time. So we're counting, imagine you tapping your foot. So it's going to be two groups of three. One, two, three, four, five, six, ba, da. One, two, three, here we go. One, two. Thank you. Okay, so I've set my click now to 76. So once you can play it at a steady speed, you can give this a try a little bit quicker. Again, you don't have to play it any quicker. You can even play it slower. The most important thing is to keep the steady pulse and keep all your ornamentation cuts and rolls steady. So here we go. Two, one, two. Da 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 da. One, two. Okay, so there we have it, the composition by Peder Oreade. I think I might have called him Sean, so my apologies for getting his name wrong at the beginning. Yeah, it's Peder Oreade, harp player. So yeah, as I say, it's not a very ancient composition, but it's a beautiful, lovely, happy kind of jolly sort of jig, which I hope you enjoy playing. Give it a go. If you found this useful in any way, please share it with other whistlers or fiddlers or whoever else you would like to share it with. It'd be really grateful if you could give it a like and hopefully even subscribe. I plan to make a few more of these videos, tune breakdowns and some specific instructional videos. As I mentioned before, I am going to do one on possibly doing some crans to add to your ornamentation base. Okay, thanks for watching and hope to see you all again very soon. Okay, take care and bye for now.